Let's take a look at several examples of using synthetic division to factors. So let's see here. The first question says, use synthetic division to factor f of x equals x cubed minus 3x, minus x squared minus x plus 1, given that f of negative 1 is 0. This negative 1 right here, that's our root. So when you plug that in to the polynomial, you would see that after you simplify that, the whole value would be equal to 0. So now, first we're going to do synthetic division. So you take your root. In that form, whatever it happens to be, whether it's positive or negative, and you put in this box, and then you complete synthetic division. Remember that if the remainder is zero in synthetic division, then you have a factor. So take a look. Set up the coefficients. Remember, the coefficients are the values, so that's 1, negative 1, negative 1, and 1. Just read those into the top row of the synthetic division setup. So it's 1, negative 1 over here. Let me zoom in. Negative 1. Then again, negative 1, and then here, positive 1. So here, you're going to bring the 1 down according to the arrow, and then you multiply. 1 times negative 1 on the outside gives negative 1, and you add straight down. Negative 1 plus negative 1 is negative 2. Negative 2 times the negative 1 here on the outside is going to give me positive 2. Negative 1 plus 2 is going to give me 1. And then 1 times negative 1. So when I add those down, it gives 0. Remember that this is the remainder. And I remember the following, that since the root is negative 1, so x equals negative 1, that's a root. If you plug that into the polynomial, you will see after you simplify that the value that comes out is 0. That's why it says f of negative 1 equals 0. Starting with this root of x equals negative 1, you can do this. You can get a factor from it by adding 1 to both sides. So you end up with x plus 1, and then on the right side, right, these are opposites, they cancel, so end up with 0. So the x plus 1 is what we call a factor. And that goes in the box. For part B, you put x plus 1. And then remember that this portion, 1 minus 2 minus 1, that represents the quotient. Our highest degree right here is, as you can see, 1x cubed. That's x cubed, the highest degree. So in the quotient, it's always 1 lower than that. So it's going to be x squared. Take a look. So over here, on the bottom, is going to be 1x squared. If you want, you can put the 1 in front of the x squared if it helps you. It's going to be minus 2x and then plus the constant, the 1. And the 0, that's the remainder. You can just ignore that. It's just 0. So now, where it says give the result from the division as a polynomial, that means you put the factor from the root, x plus 1, and then within a set of parentheses, you put the quotient. That means x squared minus 2x, like that, and then here, say, plus 1. Then it says, now give the complete factorization. That means you need to also factor the x squared minus 2x plus 1. That's a trinomial you can factor again. So what you would have is the following. Take a look. X squared minus 2x plus 1. So you're going to factor that as follows. Well, you need two numbers that multiply to 1, and the same two numbers have to add up to negative 2. So you're going to have x, let's see, minus 1, and another x minus 1. And I know that works because negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1. Negative 1 plus negative 1 is negative 2. So that means in this box, at the end, right here, you're going to put the whole factored form now. You're going to put the x plus 1, which is the first factor from the root. And then you're going to put these other two factors from the trinomial. So you're going to put x minus 1 and another x minus 1. And then the problem is complete. Let's take a look. Another example. It follows the same thinking, though. So here I have now, use synthetic division to factor the following. Let me write this so it's easier to see. It's f of x equals negative x cubed plus x squared plus x minus 1. And the other fact we're told is that f of 1 equals 0. That tells you that this is a root. X equals 1 is a root. And I know that because notice if you plug 1 in for each x and you simplify, you're going to end up with a value of 0. So when you have x equals 1 as a root, you can get a factor of the polynomial from that by doing minus 1 on both sides. So you end up with x minus 1 equals 0. These cancel. So the first factor is x minus 1. At step B, that's the first thing you can put in there if you like. X minus 1 like that, okay? So now you need to do synthetic division to get the quotient, because then the quotient has to be factored. So over here in the box, on the left side, you always put the root exactly as it's written. So I'm going to put 1. Over here in this box, 1. Positive. The root, the original positive 1. And then you put the coefficients. So in our case, it's going to be negative 1, 1, 1, negative 1. And then you do synthetic division. So you bring this down. So it's negative 1 times 1, negative 1. You add those straight down. 1 plus negative 1 is 0. You multiply 0 times the root 1. That goes over here, 0. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 times the root 1 is again positive 1. Then you add straight down. Negative 1 plus 1 is 0. So when you write this one, take a look. It's going to give you negative x squared. That's 0, so there's no x. And then plus 1. So at this point, for part B, where it says give this result from the division as a polynomial, you would put negative x squared, for example, plus 1. But then negative x squared plus 1 can be factored further. Take a look. I'm going to do it over here. Negative x squared plus 1. You can factor the negative 1 out. So it becomes on the outside negative 1. You can put that within parentheses as negative 1. When you factor negative 1 from each term of negative x squared plus 1, you got to change the signs inside. So it becomes x squared minus 1. Then you keep the negative 1. X squared minus 1 is a difference of squares. That factors into x minus 1 and then x plus 1. So that, together with the factor from the root, gives you the complete factorization. So you take the factor from the root, which is x minus 1, and now, over here in part C, you need to include the negative 1, and you need to include the x minus 1, and you have to include the other x plus 1. That's the completely factored form of the polynomial. Let's do one more for practice. So, again, take a look. You see there's a 1 in this position. That 1 represents our root. That goes into this box right here. When you say it's a root, that means the following, right? X equals 1. So then you're going to subtract 1 again. It's going to give you the following. The factor is x. Let me erase the stray mark. It becomes x minus 1 equals 0. So this value, x minus 1, is the first factor of the polynomial. So you put that in the box, x minus 1. Then to get the other factors, you need to do synthetic division. So you do the following over here. You put the coefficients from the trinomial in the top row of the synthetic division setup. So you're going to put 1, negative 1, then you're going to put negative 1, then you're going to put 1. Remember, this is coming from the fact that this is x cubed minus x squared minus x, and then this is, what is that, plus 1. Okay? It's coming from that fact. Sorry about this thing is really sensitive to touch. So the coefficients go into the top row. Then you do synthetic division. So you bring the 1 down. 1 times 1 is 1. You add straight down. Negative 1 plus 1 is 0. 1 times the 1 on the, 0 times the 1 on the outside, that's 0. You add straight down. Negative 1 plus 0, negative 1. You repeat. Negative 1 times 1, negative 1, you add straight down, 0. These are all set up so that at this point you have the value of 0. So the remainder should be equal to 0, for example, okay? Now write this down. This is the coefficient on x squared. The 0 is the coefficient on x, so that's not even present. Don't worry about it. And then you just copy the negative 1. So I have x squared minus 1. So now for part B, give the result from the division as a polynomial means you put the factor from the root, which is x minus 1. And then you put next to it the quotient, which is x squared minus 1. But again, to give the complete factorization, you need to factor x squared minus 1. So it becomes x squared minus 1, that's a difference of squares, that becomes x minus 1, and then what is that, x plus 1? So then you gotta put all of these in the last box. You put x minus 1, that's from here. Then you put these from here, so that's x minus 1, and then x plus 1. And that's the completely factored form of the polynomial. I know that it's that because if I multiply it out, it would work. It would give back the original expression. That's how I know. That's a way of checking if you wanted to check as an extra. So deliberately, I've kept all the numbers quite small just to get at the essential process so that the numbers don't get in the way. As you can see, the numbers are like, you know, very, very small numbers. Okay. Let me, the notes are available there if you are in my class. Thanks so much. I'll see you in another video.